I grew up around this mountain, and it seemed like an amazing opportunity being part of a team that's looking at something that's in your backyard.
Because of Mindy's work on the mountain, she was caught in one of the country's biggest geological disasters. After lying dormant for more than a century, Mount St. Helens suddenly awoke in March 1980. The possibility of an eruption was soon headline news. Mindy was joined by scientists from around the world, eager to study the volcano.
The quiet little mountain in the middle of nowhere that I had studied was suddenly the center of attention.
One scientist stood out from the crowd. At just 30 years old, Dr. David Johnston was already an expert in his field. Working for the U.S. Geological Survey, he had studied and lived through explosive eruptions. He was all too aware that Mount St. Helens was a ticking time bomb.
His main focus was on getting the science done as good as possible. He knew how explosive this mountain was. He wanted people to know more about it. He just knew there was no time.
Over the next few weeks, the area was hit by thousands of tremors. By late April, 3 weeks before the eruption, there was evidence of enormous pressure building inside the mountain. A huge bulge had formed on the north face, and it was slowly getting bigger.
The front face became blacker because it was wet, and so we called it the black bulge. It looked like a balloon ready to pop.
Very few people believed the bulge would actually burst. But the one man who understood Mount St. Helens better than anyone else knew differently.